Hello and welcome to this week's content tea party. I hope you can hear me well. If you can't, just pop it into the chat as usual. And I'm really happy to be back this week after a little break last week where we went for a bit of a local holiday. We didn't stay at home, but we did get down to our neighbor island, Gozo, which is part of the Maltese archipelago. And for those of you who don't know, I live in Malta, and we're actually very lucky in a way, and unlucky in another way. We were lucky at first because we didn't have a lot of COVID cases, and it came down to control really quickly. But then we opened up for tourism, being a tourist island, a little bit too fast. And then turns out that now the numbers are getting really, really large, and you know, we're beginning to isolate again, we're beginning to take precautions, and you know, we have more controls, and I believe we're going to go soon probably into another lockdown. So not much good news there. The good news is that at least in spite of the restrictions, living on a holiday island means that when you do take a holiday at home, it really does feel like a holiday. So it was a very, very well deserved, I think, and well needed break, because you know, to be constantly in the same environment, and I think this is something a lot of online entrepreneurs feel when you work from home, and you know, of course, you spend a lot of time at home with your family, then you know, you do need the change of environment, you do need to travel a little bit more so that you can break up your year a little bit more, make it a bit more exciting. Okay, so speaking of exciting, there have been some very interesting, exciting news hitting the internet this week, specifically about Facebook. And the first one is a total surprise. Facebook has actually started testing a TikTok-like feature in India. So, of course, I have not been able to access this feature yet, because I don't have an Indian Facebook account, but it seems like it's going to be a lot like TikTok. Now, this is of course very controversial, because in the meantime, TikTok is suing the Trump government for trying to ban the app, and on the other hand, Facebook is perhaps trying to even take a side entrance to that. And, you know, taking the TikTok audience before TikTok is actually banned. So that's really, really interesting over there. It's not quite TikTok-like yet. It is just a test, and they're only testing a few features. But, you know, India is a very good testing ground for this sort of thing, and we're going to see the results in the next few weeks. The second exciting tip, let's have a look. Okay, that's it. Facebook has actually just released a video series. So we only have the first one so far. And in a minute, I'm just going to pop the link so you can catch the first video and then follow all the upcoming videos that are coming. But basically what Facebook is doing, it's providing tips on how to optimize Facebook Lives and how to actually use the new Creative Studio. I don't know if you've tried to use it yet. I've tried to use this Creative Studio with my lives, and it was an absolute disaster. A lot of the features didn't work. Maybe a lot of things didn't quite work how they used to. So, you know, you expect them to work differently. So it's not a very good thing when you're going live, because when you're going live, you want to feel secure about the tips you're using, because you know that anything can happen when you're live, and you don't really want to be struggling with your technology, because, you know, you want to remember what you wanted to say, and you want to make sure that you engage with the people watching. So this is one of those things that's going to be really useful. So I'm going to grab that link in just a minute and put it in the live feed so that you can all have a look at it. Okay, and what you're going to do, I can give you a quick look. Actually, you can have a quick look at my screen, and what you can see there, you're going to see this video, and it's got a little follow button at the top, and it's going to allow you, when you click the link, to actually follow this Facebook media series, which then basically what it will do is give you a Facebook notification every time there is a new video. So there's the link. I have put it in the comments. Okay, and we don't want him to speak just yet. Okay, so today's topic is a little bit different. Today I wanted to talk about, you know, productivity versus taking breaks. I must admit, I am a little bit of a productivity geek. I have read a lot of books about productivity. Probably the most important one, not strictly a productivity book for me, was The Miracle Morning, which actually enabled me to build an online business while still running a full-time brick and mortar business. So that was a very important step. I still really do use The Miracle Morning, just not as early as 5 o'clock in the morning. But if you have not read it, I definitely recommend reading it. But when it comes to productivity, of course, we speak a lot about content. So, you know, we're talking about, we have a lot of things to do. We have to manage our business. We have to service our clients. We have to spend time marketing and creating content and then bring it all together to actually, you know, speak to prospects. Some of us make proposals. Some of us sell packages. Maybe if you're a coach, you sell packages. So, you know, it's we have to jump on those sales calls. We have to close the sales. So we are doing so much. Even if we have an assistant, you know, I've had a VA for a couple of years. I'm in between VAs at the moment. Not a very happy place. It does help to get somebody to help you and actually help keep you on track, because, you know, accountability tends to really skyrocket your productivity. So, you know, if nothing, if you think you don't have a budget for a VA, you can actually go for a VA that will just work on one or two projects, maybe specifically your content to help you out, or actually sort of manage you to keep you accountable. That's how I started off. I started off with a VA that didn't do a lot of work in the beginning. It started off at about $100 a month, and then built up to 150, and then built up to about 100 to 150 a week as I gave her more and more jobs, because I was seeing that it was actually helping me make much more money, because I was better rested. When you're better rested, you kind of do your sales calls better. So this balance between resting and productivity is very important. It's one of those things where everybody is different. And I think as women, sometimes we do feel very different. We have different cycles to men, you know, in terms of the way our body works, where our brain works. Now, there are certain times where we feel better than others. And our energy fluctuates. So it's very important to listen to how your energy is fluctuating, and also maybe leave yourself a little bit of room in terms of your schedule, so that you can have the flexibility of actually picking and choosing the kind of tasks you have to do for the day, as long as maybe, you know, you could plan. I find that it really works to plan in 1 week or 2 week chunks. Not everybody can think that way. I find 2 week chunks much more difficult than 1 week chunks. So I tend to plan more in 1 week. But I know that over that week, I'm gonna be a little bit kind to myself. I'm gonna be a bit flexible, as long as everything that needs to be done for my business and for my clients' businesses gets done. So that's very, very important. But you also need to try to fit in. And again, this is something that was recommended to me by my homeopath. And I found it really hard to follow at first. But also to have a couple of breaks during the day, a couple of breaks where you can really go for a walk by yourself or go somewhere quiet. It doesn't necessarily have to be exercise time. I prefer exercise time, you know, to do it with someone else, because accountability is important. But especially since there has been the lockdown, what I found is that taking that 10 to 20 minute break where you just go for a walk by yourself can really give you that sort of, can you really lift that sort of weight of the day off your shoulders. So, you know, to do it in the morning is going to give you a bit more energy, and doing it in the evening, it's really going to help you sort of shake off the day. So even if it's just 20 minutes, I think we can all try and do that for ourselves. And then again, of course, it's never perfect. Maybe I aim at doing it every day, but I don't get around to it every day. But if by the times I do get around to it, I can see I really feel better and I sleep better. So it's a great thing to do. And again, last week we only took, I think it was just a 4-day holiday. But it really makes a big difference, because when you're not surrounded by your devices, when you're not surrounded by your work stuff, you know, even my daughter, you know, she's in a very different place when she's on holiday. I, as a mother, am in a very different place when I'm on holiday, because I'm not constantly, you know, trying to make sure that, you know, she's disciplined and she's, you know, got all her things in order. So I'm obviously nagging a lot less on holiday, which makes me and her feel a lot more relaxed. So I think taking a good chunk, you know, a few days, it makes a really, really big difference. Another thing that I find makes a big difference with the kids, and this is actually scientifically proven, you could actually pop it into Google and it will explain why, is giving your kids one day a week where it is device free. Now, I do it for myself because I find that, you know, when I have too much access to my devices, I tend to go into overdrive, because, you know, I'll be looking at Facebook, looking at Instagram, looking at all these apps. I'll have ads running maybe, and I've got social media posts going out, and I've got blogs that are being published. So I want to check everything. And then I find that people are commenting and I'm engaging with them. And then I find myself in a group, and, you know, it ends up eating up so much of your time. But in spite of the fact that you're not at work and you're maybe sitting at home comfortably on the sofa, what you don't realize is that it's still really sapping the energy, because our brain is in overdrive trying to keep up with all these distractions that keep coming up everywhere. And I don't know the scientific term. There is actually a term for this, and that releases a particular chemical, which the name of which escapes me right now. I think it's serotonin. I'm not perfectly sure. But if you look it up, there has been research that found that basically, if you give yourself that one day a week where you do not have all these impulses going into your brain and all these distractions, it does help you focus better, and it also helps you stay a bit more grounded. Because what it does is it basically allows the brain to get bored, and it allows the brain to get unhooked from these constant chemicals, these exciting chemicals that Facebook and video games and, you know, these lovely things we like to watch on Netflix, they're just all feeding us with these, you know, pleasure chemicals that come from our brain. So when we take a break, we actually starve our brain of that chemical for 24 hours. And it's really good for us, because in the long run, we become more and more resistant to these chemicals and we actually start enjoying it less. So that is why it's very important to have a break. I also see a difference in the way my daughter actually reacts to discipline. When I control at least once per week how much access she gets to devices. The main reason is, you know, it's one of those things when you're on the internet. I think kids learn at a very early age that when they're on the internet, everything is exciting. And they're in control of everything. And then, you know, they come to the real world and they're not in control. They're being told what to do. So the contrast for them can be very, very uncomfortable. So, hi, Jacqueline. I can see you join me. I can't see your full question, though. Feel free to jot down a full question. There doesn't seem to be a full question there. Excellent. So what I was saying is that, you know, starving yourself of this constant constant interruption, this constant pop-ups on Facebook is really going to make a big difference to your productivity as well. I actually use something which is just a free feed blocker for Chrome. So if you go to Chrome and you find your extensions, you can download this little tool, which is called Facebook Feed Blocker. So when you need to go on Facebook to post your own stuff, or you need to check certain groups because it's your own group, then you don't get drawn into what other people are doing because of your feed. And I think it takes a decision. You've got to say, you know, I am now going to stop being this super distracted consumer and I'm going to become a creator. So, you know, the way you start thinking about your use of the platforms is going to make a big difference to your productivity. And I really suggest looking at the Facebook blocker extension. It's I think, available also on other browsers, potentially on Firefox as well. So no matter what browser you use, try to see if you find the Facebook feed blocker. And what it does is it just removes all these notifications from your friends, and it puts a nice relaxing quote. So it just puts a quote instead on your feed. And of course, you can still visit all these other places, and you can also use Messenger to send messages, and you can use quite a lot of stuff. When you've finished work, you can, of course, just switch it off, refresh your browser, and you can use Facebook for pleasure. But at least while you're working, you stop going down the rabbit hole. You stop this habit of, you know, I've got 5 minutes to just paste in a post and go. And 5 minutes are more than enough. But of course, it ends up taking me 20 or 50 minutes because I've gone down the rabbit hole. Yes, I can see. Jacqueline is saying, I feel that. Okay, let's see. Okay. It looks like it's appearing on the screen, but I don't have the right color. So let's see if this works a little bit better. Okay. Okay, let's see if this works a little bit better. So Jacqueline is saying, I feel that all this is about choice, definitely, and trusting the process that you will still have clients, even if you aren't in line all the time. Yes, absolutely. It's also being able to let yourself off the hook for a bit, not feeling like you need to be constantly at your computer, not feeling like you have to be constantly pushing, because I think this is one of the reasons why we end up burning out, and we end up doing everything at a much lower quality than we normally would if we had to give it the time it actually needs and wants as a project as well. So definitely, I'm totally with you, Jacqueline. Totally, totally. Yes, and it also goes in trusting the process. I know what you mean when you mean trusting the process, although I hear it a lot from different people where you're like, okay, this is the process and this is how you launch and you've got to do it like this. And it involves, you know, sending 50 emails in the last 5 days. And so I understand that when you mean trusting the process, it means just, you know, trusting your intuition. And let me know if I'm right, because I'm interpreting what you're saying. But I believe, Jacqueline, you mean that we, you know, listen to our intent, to our own intuition, and to the way, you know, we need to do things. We don't need to. Sometimes I think what happens to a lot of people is that we see these influencers out there, but what we don't see is the 10, 20 people they have working behind the scenes. That's why they're on YouTube. They're also on Facebook. They're also doing emails. They're doing their podcasts. They're doing their daily blogs. They're doing so much stuff. So we've got to be a little bit careful with who we compare ourselves to, and also understand what business phase we're in and what our next business phase is. Because I think one of the reasons why my own business a few years ago, my online side of the business was stuck for quite a while, was because I didn't understand the business stage I was in. I had already had another business that I had opened in 2008. So, you know, we had quite a lot of employees. We had, I think, 11 or 12 employees at the time. And, you know, it's like I didn't feel like a beginner when I started the online business. So I didn't kind of act like a beginner. And I think this is one thing that really was no good for my business in the beginning, because I needed to understand the stage of the business I was in, accept the reality of that, and then act my stage, you know, because sometimes when you think you're further than you are, you kind of do things and you don't understand why they don't work. So I think that was a very, very big lesson for me. Okay, so if you have any any productivity tips. So let me know if, you know, how, what breaks you've taken, how you take breaks regularly, especially, you know, with all these different countries going into lockdown and having different rules about COVID, you know, let me know what you have done to keep your productivity up, what you're struggling with. You know, I would really like to especially hear your feedback on how you stay productive, you know, especially if you have kids at home, if you're constantly in the same environment because you were in lockdown, and, you know, where you went on holiday, if you did. So let me know how you are trying to stay productive at this time, because I think it's a lesson that we can all learn from. It's, you know, pooling information because it's new for everyone. And I think that we still have at least another 6 months to go. So anything we can learn to navigate this better is going to be really, really useful to all of us. Once again, I thank you very much for being with me. I would like to let you know that we will soon be shifting again to the winter schedule. So as soon as August is over, we will be moving back to Fridays, and there will be a new schedule. But just wait for the post, because it will be a new slot. It will be different from usual. So just wait for my post and I will give you all the details. If you want to make sure to catch it, you can either go to my website, stephaniefitani.com, and jump on the email list, or you can join my group, which is called More Leads and Traffic with Content and SEO. So if you can search that into Facebook, you can also find it on my profile, or you can follow the page, although the page, you know, Facebook doesn't show what you post to a lot of people. So I don't trust it that much these days. So the best thing to do is to go in the group, because then when I create the event there, everybody gets to see it. Okay, excellent. Thank you so much. I hope you have a good evening or morning or afternoon, wherever you are in the world. And I will see you again next week.